Well, it's time for some entertainment news, and the big release is Spider-Man Far From Home. Oh my God, look who's in the studio, Spider-Man himself. So good to have you, and absolutely fit as always, but I'm going to do the talking because he can't talk, thankfully. I have interviewed Tom Holland, the guy inside you, literally. So here's my interview with Tom Holland. Let's see what he had to say. Tom, great to see you.
Nice to see you too.
You know, this is the fourth time you'll be playing Spider-Man when the film comes out.
Yeah.
That must be exciting.
I mean, it's kind of crazy to me, the idea that I've been playing this character for nearly 5 years, I think, it's just insane. It's insane, and time has flown by, which I guess is a kind of example of how much I love making these movies.
Right.
And how happy I am to be a part of this amazing world.
Right.
So it's been pretty great.
Right. So 5 years, if I ask you, what is the most exciting thing of playing Spider-Man, getting into the suit, what would you say?
It's kind of this moment now, you know, traveling the world, promoting the movie,
right,
building the hype of the movie coming out, and people getting excited to see it.
Right.
So for me, it's kind of this process of getting everyone excited for the movie.
Right. You know, when you're a part of Avengers, there are so many actors driving the movie.
Mm-hmm.
In a film like that, it's just you. Is that exciting? Is that pressure?
Well, I wouldn't say it's just me. You know, we're very lucky to have Jake Gyllenhaal. We have the incredible Sam Jackson.
Right.
Zendaya plays a much bigger role than this, and I think people are going to fall in love with her character all over again.
Right.
Jacob Batalon, Kobe Smulders is in this movie. So it's a really, really exciting
team
of people to be working with, and kind of a unique team for the MCU.
Right. You know, from the trailers, tell me, is he a romantic? Is Peter Parker very romantic? Will we see that side in the movie?
Yes, we will get to see a more romantic side to Peter Parker in this film, but it's not romantic. He's not grown up in any way about his romance. He's very young. He's very sort of naive and excited and very cute about the way he goes about his romance.
Similar to Hugh in real life or different?
Actually, yeah, it is quite similar. Yeah, there are some similarities, sure.
Right. You know, also from the trailer we can make out that he misses Iron Man. Over the years, how would you describe this relationship?
I mean, it's an interesting one because it's developed over, you know, a few years now. I think at the beginning it started off with this kind of exciting adventure, this new chapter in his life, going to Germany to fight Captain America and stuff.
Right.
And then they became this kind of big brother, little brother kind of relationship in Spider-Man Homecoming. And then in Avengers Infinity War, they were more like friends because he started answering back to him, which I thought was really funny. And then I think in Endgame, it really is like a father-son sort of relationship. So it's a big loss for Peter Parker, and it is a huge loss for everyone else who's a fan of the movies.
Right.
But yeah, he will be missed.
Right. And also, you both have huge fan following in India and the world world over. How's your relationship with Robert Downey Jr?
He's one of the coolest people ever.
Yeah.
You know, it's so nice as a young person coming up in this industry to meet and get to work with someone who's at the top of the game.
Right.
But is a lovely person. You know, he's like, he's always on time. Mm. He's super hardworking. He's so professional. He's kind to the crew.
Mm.
And it's just a nice thing to be able to see someone in his position be so nice.
Right. You know, when you're promoting the film and you're talking about it to your fans and others, you know, how do you manage to not give out spoilers? What is that a training?
Well, at the beginning of the film, I didn't really keep spoilers to myself. I used to just like telling people about them.
Right.
I mean, you have to really think about what you're saying.
Hmm.
And you meet some journalists and they're very sneaky and they ask you questions because they're trying to catch you out.
Right.
So thank you for not being one of those journalists. But yeah, you just have to think before you say anything. Yeah.
Right. And are you better with Instagram stories and posts, or are you getting better?
I'm not too bad. I'm not massively into Instagram.
No.
I like going on it and like sort of
checking out
stuff, but I never really post.
Right.
When I'm on the press tour, I get pretty active.
Right.
But I'm not massively into kind of
posting. So where do you interact with your fans? Where can they contact you when they may expect a reply or something?
On Instagram, you know, if people comment and stuff, sometimes I'll comment back and that's kind of what I love about Instagram, is that it's a platform for all of us to communicate without giving out my phone number.
Right. And also, if you know, when a script comes to you and it has a lot of spoilers, what is the script like? How do you make sense of it, because you don't know so much of it?
Well, a lot of the script is redacted.
Right.
So a lot of it is kind of blacked out, so you can't really read it.
Mm-hmm.
So what they'll do is they'll invite you into the studio and you go and sit in a room and read it in a room.
Right.
which I actually never did on this movie. I just read the redacted version.
Right.
And then John Watts kind of filled me in, because a lot of the stuff that was redacted had nothing to do with Spider-Man.
Right.
Yeah.
And also lastly, what is the set of a Spider-Man like? Can you make out what's happening and how it'll look on eventually?
It depends on what we're shooting. I mean, you know, we shot a lot of this film on location.
Right.
Which we didn't the first time around.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when you're shooting in Venice, you know that it's going to look like Venice and Prague. But sometimes you're on set and there's nothing but green screen.
Right.
And you're fighting an imaginary water monster.
Right.
So that can be quite interesting. And what's quite fun about that is you don't know how the movie's going to turn out.
Right.
So you have to just wait and see at the premiere.
Great. This is such a cool movie, such a cool superhero. You're such a cool guy. Thank you for talking to us.
Thanks very much. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
And now the most important question, how is the film? I'm scared of Spider-Man. Here's my review. I've seen the film. Going by his review, it'll be great. Here's what I have to say about the movie. Spider-Man Far From Home has released. I'm so excited about this film. I was excited before watching it. I'm excited after watching it. John Watts has directed this one. Tom Holland, as we know, plays Spider-Man. And Jake Gyllenhaal plays Mysterio. This is the first Spider-Man movie that doesn't entirely take place in New York. And how long can we see him flying around these tall buildings of New York? So this time, Peter Parker wants to go on a school vacation with all his friends to Europe. What happens is quite amazing. When he reaches there, there's destruction, there's lots happening there. So he's witnessing these crazy action scenes right in front of him. And trust me, this is jaw-dropping action. Keep your eyes wide open during these scenes. He's in Venice, there's a lot of destruction, and that's caused by Mysterio, of course. That's when Peter Parker is abducted by Nick Fury and SHIELD agents because they want him to do the right thing and save the world. In many ways, this is a high school drama. In many ways, this is obviously a superhero film. The transition between these two is absolutely fantastic. Peter Parker wants to impress MJ on this trip, and those scenes are absolutely adorable. He can be such a cute, good lover boy, and then cut to Spider-Man saving the world. The good thing about our lead man is that you see him evolve, you see him grow. On one side, he's running around this girl, trying to woo her. On the other side, he's doing the right things, trying to fill Tony Stark's shoes, and that's a big responsibility. Though Iron Man is not in this movie, his presence is throughout in the film, from the first frame to the last frame. This film belongs to the two men, that's Tom Holland and Jake Gyllenhaal. Tom Holland is a young guy, he can play Spider-Man for many years, I'm sure. Jake Gyllenhaal is such a show stealer here. Every time he comes as Mysterio, those scenes are absolutely fantastic. At just 2 hours and 10 minutes, this is such a paisa vasool film. Should you watch it? You should watch it ASAP. Well, that's all we have from the world of entertainment. Spider-Man, thank you for coming to the NDTV studio. See you soon.